The fact that there had been so many violations so often should have hardly come as a surprise if more attention had been paid to what Yasser Arafat himself declared in a speech made on May the 10th, 1994 in Johannesburg, only a few months after the signature of the Oslo agreements.
This had to be understood for everybody. And for this, I was insisting before signing to have a letter from them, from the Israelis, that Jerusalem is one of the items which has to be under discussion. And not the state, the permanent state of Israel. No, it is the permanent state of Palestine. Yes, it is the permanent state of Palestine. This agreement, I'm not considering it more than the agreement which had been signed between our Prophet Muhammad and Quraysh.
This is one of the numerous instances in which Yasser Arafat explains that, in fact, an agreement signed with the enemy is only valid as long as it serves your goals, which was the case with the agreement signed by Muhammad with a tribe that controlled Mecca. He indeed said all he wanted was to get across to the Mecca to pray there. But when the Quraysh tribe became weaker, Muhammad attacked it and wiped it out.
2 years after the PLO signed the agreement with Israel and committed himself to peace and to fighting the Hamas, it did just the opposite. It signed an agreement with Hamas on the ways in which Hamas will continue to do terrorist acts with in agreement with the PLO. And here is the copy of the agreement as reported in an Arabic paper, Al-Quds, of the day of the signing. And what it shows here, the two sides signing, one, the head of the chairman of the Palestinian National Council, Salim Zanun, on the right side, on the left side, Khaled Mash'al, the head of the political department of the Hamas. And what it says in several items is basically that Hamas will not embarrass the Palestinian Authority. It will act in the ways that is agreed between them. In this paper, they detailed these negotiations and the two proposals. One of the PLO, headed by Yasser Arafat, and the other by the Hamas, headed by Sheikh Ahmad Yassin.
Habibna, 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 Ahmad Yassin.
What it basically said, and we should focus on the formula that the PLO suggested on the left side, the PLO offered Hamas the following. You can continue your operations against Israel as long as you A. do not take openly credit for it, and B. you act only from other territories, not from Area A, which is under our PLO's control.
In spite of his commitments, as detailed in the Oslo Accords, and which he does not consider as binding, Yasser Arafat hints repeatedly that, indeed, once the present goals have been achieved, this will not be the end of the process. Supposing that the Palestinian territorial demands were satisfied, Israel would still have a small chance of surviving, despite the size it will have been reduced to. The Palestinian strategy, however, has other plans. To insist that all descendants of the Arab refugees from 1948, that is to say 4 million Muslims, be allowed to return to Israel. An immigrant inflow of over two-thirds of the present Israeli population.
فلسطين للفلسطينيين ونقول حق العودة حق العودة حق العودة حق العودة حق العودة
أن شعبنا مع السلام العادل والشامل سلام الشجعان ولن يقبل بالعودة لما كان قبل السلام، كما أننا لن نتساهل ولن نسمح لأحد بالعبث بأمن الطرفين، بأمن الطرفين، بأمن الطرفين، وأننا سنواجه كل محاولة العنف والعبث بالأمن أيا كان مصدره، أيا كان مصدره، أيا كان مصدره.
World public opinion has been carefully prepared during the seven-year peace process. None of these images show Arafat's double language, and the real Palestinian strategy remained within the Arab communities. All that remained to do was blow up the Middle East and perhaps the rest of the world. Ariel Sharon's visit to Mount Temple was not enough. There had to be a larger impact, more radical. On the 31st of September 2000, President Clinton manages to impose a ceasefire between the two parties. The unexplained presence of a child caught in the midst of crossfire provoked by the Palestinian police, and the even more surprising presence of a Palestinian cameraman a few meters from the drama, was to change the situation and drive the entire Arab nation into an unequaled hate and rejection of Israel.
فاليهود هم اليهود سواء كانوا عملا أو لقود، فاليهود هم اليهود، ولن يكون فيهم معتدل ولا داعية للسلام، فكلهم كاذبون. هؤلاء هم الذين يجب أن يذبحوا ويجب أن يقتلوا، كما قال الله تبارك وتعالى: قاتلوهم يعذبهم الله بأيديكم ويخزهم وينصركم عليهم ويشف صدور قوم مؤمنين.
انتفاضة الأقصى، هذه الانتفاضة يخطئ من يظن أنها حدثت بسبب زيارة الحقير شارون إلى المسجد الأقصى، وإن كانت هي القشة التي قسمت صفر الشعب الفلسطيني، ولكن هذه الانتفاضة كانت معدة سابقا منذ عودة القائد الرئيس من مفاوضات كامب ديفيد الأخيرة، ولكن هذه الانتفاضة كانت معدة سابقا